I'm bringing financial literacy at the college. So, Madam Jyoti Bhagat, please. So, we can have the camera person here for the photo. Please.
Income we have, how we are doing the budgeting part, how we will meet our break-even points. So this is all the number games. But the problem is the entrepreneur who started their career at 21 years, 22 years. They do not have the basic knowledge of these things. So for that, I believe this session. Yeah, you want to say something? Okay. So for this kind of a, you can say, webinar, workshop, we require. So we have our session chair, Mr. G.P. Garg, Executive Director, SEBI Mumbai. So prior to his promotion as Executive Director, Mr. Garg was Chief General Manager in SEBI and has handled several assignments since joining in January 1994. He has been associated with SEBI initiative in financial literacy and investment education in the country. Mr. Garg played key role in establishment of National Institute of Security Market and ISM, including setting up the new state of the art campus at Patalganga. So welcome, sir.
So yeah, the G.P. Garg sir can maybe have his views first. So over to Mr. Garg, please. Yes, sir. You can start because you had already asked the question in terms of your views on the theme of the youth panel on the basic financial literacy for the youth.
And thank you so much this important topic of the youth, the financial literacy team, enhancing funding. Jeffrey School, Angam, and Mr. Hassan Yaqub, Chairman E-commerce Council EP and Associate Director, Group Flipkart, Lucknow. I also welcome all the guests who are there in person or who are online from all parts of the country. To begin with, thank you once again for inviting me. It's always a great pleasure. There is a program in Lucknow and something in Awok India, which is the only investor association recognized by SEBI in Uttar Pradesh. Organizes it, they always organize in a very, very nice way. So thank you all the organizers for this wonderful initiative. To begin with, this is one question that why do we need the financial literacy for the youth? Let me put it, we have the academician like Madam Meena Nair. According to me, this is one of the biggest life skill of 21st century for all of us. In the beginning, Mr. Gaurav mentioned that only 24% of Indians are financially literate. That cannot be the bad thing for anyone to hear for a country which has the more than 80% of plus literacy. It means the financial literacy lags behind the general literacy in the country. And that's one area we have to fix as fast as possible. To begin for the youth, actually, why it is so important, to me, whatever financial concepts we have, whether it's long-term compounding, something which gives you the real return, they all work if you start early in your investment. So for all the youth, I'll say that your first mantra in life should be pay yourself first. Means invest first and spend later. That's my first thing to begin all the youth who are here or who are attending this program. Today I would also like to tell one more thing that those who are highly successful in their investments, they have to look for another concept called your passive salary. Active salary is what we get every day. But I know that if you start early in your youth, by the time you are in 40s, probably you have such a good investment that your passive salary can be more than your active salary. And then you can decide whether you really want to have a proper job or what more avenues can open up for you. It means that can only happen when you start early, when you start in your youth, and for that, financial literacy is the key. Financial literacy is not just just a skill alone, it subsequently becomes your habit. Because I have seen that in a modern society where there are large number of uncertainties relating to your job or other areas, if you have if you are a good investor and if your financial your finances are strong, you can actually absorb all kind of shocks. COVID has given us the biggest shock of the century, and we know that how much vulnerability has come into picture for those who have not planned their finances well. So I would ask all the youth to please start financial literacy as an important life skill and implement it in your day-to-day life. Because if you have a financial planning, if you investment plan for your long run, no one can stop you from having a decent life and to achieve important life goals. Particularly, I say all your financial goals one can expect in his lifetime. And in this Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, we are celebrating 75th year of India's independence. Let us also think that apart from independence we have, can we achieve the state of individual financial freedom or individual financial independence? It means you have your finances so well managed that at one stage you feel that finance is one worry you are not having in your life. So that's another suggestion to me for the youth. The financial literacy and investment leads to more development of the economy, creation of the more jobs, more taxes, and less burden on the system. So whatever the infrastructure or large number of projects what we are dreaming of, they cannot be completed unless all of us become good investor, put our money in the good financial instruments which gives you decent return, but that also leads to money which is required for the country. I'm very happy that some portion of our money is now put in the security market, whether you save it by pension or by way of your EPFO, that also comes to the system. Unfortunately, as I mentioned earlier, the state of financial literacy in our country is not good. As per 2019 survey, only 27% of Indians are financially literate. I am extremely disappointed to say that in case of UP, our data says that only 21% of Uttar Pradesh population is financially literate. So there is a huge, things to do. There is a long, road ahead if you want to make our youth and the whole society in the state of UP financially literate. Let me also say, when it comes to the age group of 18 to 29 years, in case of UP, only 5% of our population is putting their money in the capital market. And if I say the national average, which is 8%, it means we are far behind when it comes to Uttar Pradesh. Likewise, financial well-being, if I tell for the youth of the country, only 16% of youth are clear about their financial goals when we did a survey. It means not even 1/5 of our young population is clear about their financial goals, what they want to achieve in life. Similarly, if we ask them that are they clear what they will do on their retirement, the question is very simple, but they have absolutely no idea. They are not confident that what whether they have any action plan for that, because we all have to what they retire also. And if we ask them whether they will have the able to maintain their life standards when they have to, if they don't have a job or if they have to retire, absolutely the number is only 21%. So what I'm trying to say that the state of financial literacy is very poor, and that is the same even for the youth. And it's a very appropriate forum to discuss that how important the early financial literacy is. And out of given you the reason, now I give you over to Gaurav. You may have more questions and discussions with the other panelists, and maybe later part of my discussion I can tell you what SEBI is doing, what we are doing through National Centre for Financial Education, and what could be the road ahead. I would request other panelists to kindly share their thoughts about the importance of financial literacy in the life of youth, and how it can become important tool for the financial empowerment.
Recording in progress.
So I would like to introduce our panelists, Mr. Suresh Shukla from Kotak Securities. Mr. Shukla started his career as management training with Kotak Securities in the old branch in 1996. Initial 10 years he was involved developing the central Indian market for Kotak Securities and was heading centralized till 2007. 2007, Mr. Shukla was promoted as regional manager East in 2009. He was promoted as regional manager North. 2015, he was again promoted as India business head for branch business. Additionally, in 2018, he started heading B2B business as well. 2020, Mr. Shukla was given additional charge of digital business for the firm. As of now, he is a business head, branches, franchisee, and digital business. His exposure largely has been on retail equity capital, capital market, advisory, mutual fund, and IPO. So, sir, my question related with the financial literacy is to you. In UP or in India, if you see that a lot of startup, a lot of SHGs, and now FPOs are also joining e-commerce platform, like Hassan is here. So now they are also starting their business in a modern society. They are, you can say, they are also improving their literacy in terms of these things. So how we can aware these micro sector, so they can create their own concept loan or some hand holding, so that they can easily take the loan from the bank, because most of the rejection rate is because their project plan is not good, their concept node is not good. So how we can solve this problem?
Okay, thanks Gaurav. So good afternoon everybody, and thanks for having me here. I am truly delighted to be part of this event, and I would like to congratulate Awoke India and Praveen ji for taking up this initiative, putting efforts on making India more financially intelligent. Before coming to your question, Gaurav, I would like to give some background to what I feel about the issue. Largely, I would like to touch upon how bad it is as of now, what are the reasons for that, and what possibly can happen or is happening. So as everybody mentioned, Mr. Garg mentioned, our financial literacy is just 24%, as against Western world about maybe 60-80%. The worrisome part is, even if you look at the emerging markets like Brazil, China, Russia, even South Africa. Yeah. So even within the emerging market, we are bottom of the table. All other emerging markets are anywhere between 30% to 40%. We are at roughly about 20%. Now, why do I think it is the way it is? My personal thoughts are largely there are two, three reasons. All of us know till late 90s, India was a country with very high interest rate regime. If you put bank FD, you'll easily get 12 to 13% return. And a risk adjusted, if you compare it with any other asset class, it was a no-brainer. Because 12-13% safe return in fixed instrument was like a dream. So a lot of people, or majority of the people, were happy with that. So there was nobody wanted to explore other avenues like equity. At best, somebody who had surplus money will put other than FDs into gold or real estate. Second reason, I think, is up till late 90s, our Indian middle class was very small, before this IT thing happened, this BPO thing happened. So in turn, the surplus, investable surplus, was also very small. So therefore, no need to do anything. Third thing, there was no structural effort to make sure this awareness is going up from all the stakeholders. So this is how we were. I'll just quickly tell you some numbers which will make it clear. Today, if you look at population of India is about 135 crores. Number of Aadhaar card would be around 129 crores. Bank account will be about 80% penetration, 105 crores, thanks to Jan Dhan. I think Jan Dhan contributed about 44 crores bank account. Number of PAN card holders is about 33 crores. This number I'm talking about, which is linked to the Aadhaar, it may be slightly higher, actual number may be slightly higher than this. Number of people filing IT return is just 6 crores. Now here comes the scary thing. If you look at the number of mutual fund folios, it's just about 5%, which is roughly 4% of population. Now you come to number of DMAT accounts which are active. When I say active, I mean any account which has put even one trade in last 12 rolling months is about just 2.65 crores, which is just not even 2% of your population. Again, going to other part of the globe, for Western world, it's about 50% or slightly more than that. Or even a country like China, it is close to 20%. So this is where we are. What needs to be done and what is being done, I'll just quickly try and cover that up. I can clearly see the awareness happening. The testimony to the fact is this event itself, Awoke India Foundation doing this event to make sure people are getting financially literate. So that's a testimony to the fact people are aware now. They are trying to do things about it. RBI in 2013 came out with the revision document a strategy on financial inclusion. And basically they were putting focus on 5 C's. One was content, to make sure content is available at the school, college level curriculum. Capacity, to create the capacity. Third is community learning. Fourth is communication. And fifth was collaboration. So what we see here today is a testimony to that collaboration. All of us needs to contribute on that, and that is what is happening there. I'm very happy to see that. That's on side of the institutions and government. Another major impact which has happened here is a lot of fintechs, a lot of private players, and a lot of good decisions by regulators. For example, this Mutual Fund Sahi Hai campaign. It has just doubled the number of folios from 2017 to 2021. It's massive. Although we are still not there in terms of penetration, but it's massive. If I talk about a lot of fintechs now coming out with a lot of good portals where you can, you can find, there's an abundance of information. You just go there, you'll find information flowing. Third is penetration of internet. Penetration of internet is something that has helped to a great extent, especially in Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3 cities. If you go today, see social media, YouTube or Twitter, it is full of content on maybe investing, stock investing, or all other asset classes. And the best part about this is available on the vernacular language. So a lot of people are getting educated from that. And another part is product innovation. Especially in capital markets, last 3-4 years, there have been immense work has happened on the product innovation. Product innovation like SIPs is not a household name. Now you have stock SIPs also. So putting all these things put together, I think lot has started happening. Now, I am personally very bullish on this, because if you see some data in detail, for example, your financial literacy for our adult population is, let's say, 20 to 24%. But if you see age-wise bucketing, population below 30 years of age, that literacy percentage is close to 35%. That's a good sign. Whatever number of DMAT accounts which are getting opened every month, there's a furious growth in that. About let's say 1.5-2 years back, industry as a whole, we used to open about 4 to 5 lakhs DMAT account a month. Now, it started picking up after this pandemic for whatever reason, and now it is about 35 lakhs account per month. You know, so from 4 lakh, 5 lakh account a month to 35 lakh account per month. So definitely, all these things are contributing immensely. And if I talk about the demography of new accounts which we are opening, more than 60% are coming from the millennials. You know, who are age below 30 years. So that's a very good sign. Because these are the set of people who will be making money over a period of time, and it is important for them to be judicious with their investment decision. So as a capital market professional, I am very bullish, and I can see things happening at various sectors, be it regulator, be it Government of India, be it people like Praveen ji. Everybody is trying to contribute. So I see a great future here. That's what my thoughts.
Thanks. Well, thank you, Suresh ji. How RBI introduced this 5C thing, up fintech and all those things. So now I'm introducing our second panelist, Meena Nair ji. Starting off as a teacher, she became a coordinator, principal, trusting head curriculum designer, project manager and general manager, and now she is the associate vice president and academic head of St. M.R. Jaipuria Group of Schools, managing more than 40 schools all over India. Throughout her career, she continued learning and has 2 master's degree and an MPhil as well, and diploma from IIT Delhi and IIM Ahmedabad. She has been an editor of e-magazines and newsletters, and have authored more than 50 books for school children. She has received Management Excellence Award from S. Chand Group 2009, AWWA Award of Excellence in 2011, Exceptional Woman of Excellence Award by Women Economic Forum 2018, Weaving Dream and Excellence Award at International Con and Human Literacy Delhi 2018. So welcome, Meena Nair ma'am. And ma'am, as all the panelists are talking about why this financial literacy is low and how we can increase, and apart from this, please mention how we can involve in our basic curriculum or maybe in the basic learning, so that the children or students can at least have an idea of the financial literacy. Yeah, ma'am.
First of all, a very good evening to all of you, and thanks to technology for helping me connect to people in Lucknow. I was supposed to be in Lucknow, but unfortunately I could not travel. I am in Delhi. But St. M.R. Jaipuria schools are all over in UP, so half of the time I am in Lucknow only. I would like to welcome my co-panelists here, and a wonderful topic to discuss. So financial literacy, I would say that it is the ability to understand and effectively use various financial skills. Very, very important in these times for children to understand. If I talk about 5 basic principles of financial literacy, it is basically about what you are earning, how much you are spending, how much you are investing or borrowing, and how much you are protecting. So these are the basic things of financial when I talk about 5 principles of financial literacy. And you have to have an understanding of core areas like budgeting, you know, setting some goals, and also like how to pay the bills and how to save money, and you know, understand the basics of loans, credit card, everything. So I think very important. Why it is a very key word, buzzword now, like visual literacy. Because the children should know what is financial literacy, and in school itself, a curriculum should have this financial literacy inculcated in the curriculum right from the primary class. So I would like to give some ways that then only the, by the time they reach, they will, when they reach youth, like teenagers, will start valuing money. So if I talk about very early, how you can give that feeling of, you know, what small terms, what I said, to teach financial literacy at a very early stage, I'm talking about primary children, you can play games that involve money. And using play money, and later on slowly we can give them the value of money, and then make a wish list with the children. What are the wish list? What you want, and if you have to achieve that wish list, you need to have to budget the money for that. Then once again, what I feel that what I do in my school is that my schools, what I tell that please teach the children the importance of money by shop, and you give them pocket money and help them manage how to manage their allowances, and then split the money into various categories. That also has to be inculcated right from the school age itself. Involved, I would say, when the children go from primary to say middle school, say when they are about 10-12 years of age, the teachers and the parents should involve the children in major purchasing. This is a brand which is costing this much money, this is a budget, this is allowing us to buy or not allowing us to buy. And then slowly when they reach their teens, you have to have the financial counseling. So I would like to tell one more thing before I hand over the forum to other panelists. CPSC, I handled 42 schools and closely work with CPSC. And they have come up with a skill development curriculum. And last year they have beautifully created a booklet collaborating with the National Payment Corporation of India, NPCI. And there is a curriculum which the children can opt financial literacy right from class 6 onwards. In all my schools, I have given this as an option for the children to use. And to learn this curriculum very beautifully, written. Understanding what is banking. I told you the key words like what is budgeting, what is the importance of saving, and then how you manage your money for future. So this, from 6 onwards, it has to be inculcated. So CBSE has developed a curriculum, and in the skill development course, so there is financial literacy, a course has been developed which is starting from class 6 onwards. I would request all the people here to, in case I know that all our parents, teachers, and please, if the child, if you have children or if you are coming across with children, please ask them to go through this curriculum and understand, and let them understand and feel the importance of this particular literacy. We talk a lot about literacy and numeracy. So literacy has become a very overused word. But when you add this financial aspect to it, it becomes a little heavy word. And yes, very important for the children to know, because they have to earn that respect for money, right? They have to understand the respect for money and how to manage it. And only these courses, which start very early, I told you, from the primary stage, moving to the secondary stage, and then when they reach the senior secondary stage, we should have the counseling sessions in the school, so that the children know about the value of money. I think thanks to pandemic, last almost 2 years, the children were at home. They have involved with the school home management with the parents, so they. Most of my children have understood the value of money now, and the value of time also now. And I think that is a gain, I would say, that when they were, otherwise what happens is, generally when the children go, everything goes around the children, they go to the school and they come back, they don't know how the parents are managing their house. Now, most of my children for last year during pandemic, this was one of the key skills that I tried to inculcate in my students. And I told you small tips that how did we do. So only then, when you start early, then you can have a youth who is much more aware of what money is, how to manage it, and how a career can get them a better money, and how education helps them to, you know, like get a better financial literacy for them, and then how to manage their life and be happy. So this is what I just want to tell you. Over to the rest of the panelists, I can add up as and when the you know, the questions come to me. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. As you suggested that it's not only in a curriculum, even the parents should teach the children in terms of the games and all. We have a business simulation game. So such kind of games can be developed for the children so that they can understand the basic financial literacy. So I would like to introduce our third panelist, Mr. Hasan Yaqub. Mr. Hasan Yaqub is a renewed name in corporate world in UP. He has vast professional experience, 22 years, and worked with Vodafone, Idea, Reliance Industries, Lens Communication, and Ministry of HRD. He is a legal expert in cybercrime and has a leading advocate of Lucknow High Court as well, before coming to the corporate world. He is a chairman, e-commerce council of CII UP, associate director, Group Flipkart, and also honorary advisor to DDMA, Lucknow Government of UP. He has been admired by Honorable Governor of UP, Deputy CM, and Government Stakeholder at several instances for his dedicated contribution for the upliftment of the state and bringing glory to Uttar Pradesh through his corporate excellence. So, welcome, Hasan.
Thank you, Gaurav.
So, Hasan, as you already have a legal degree and you already practice this, nowadays we are moving to the digital world. Even all the transaction is happening through UPI and all these platforms. But our ecosystem is not that smart or mature enough. Even people are not aware. So a lot of, you can say, cyber crime is happening in terms of this finance as well. So what is your thought, how we can improve this, or how we can create awareness in terms of the cyber crime or money theft and all this?
First of all, Gaurav, thank you for the nice question. And firstly, I would like to congratulate Praveen ji and entire team of Awoke India for organizing such a nice, meaningful initiative and event, and inviting me and all the eminent guests here. My all regards to the dignitaries, patient listeners. बल्कि मैं ये कहूँ कि अपनी अपनी ज़िंदगी में सफल गाथाओं के रचयिता आप लोग सब हैं. मेरे हम्बल रिगार्ड्स आप सबको. नाउ वी स्पीक अबाउट द फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी, बिकॉज आई एम अ पर्सन हु इज़ फ्रॉम द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ टेलीकॉम, ई कॉमर्स, डिजिटल एज. एज पर मी, फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ नॉलेज, अवेयरनेस, skill attitude, which help a person take his financial decisions. जिंदगी बहुत लंबी है और देखा जाए जिंदगी बहुत छोटी है. Life is uncertain. So it is expected from a wise head of the family member, yeah, each individual to take right decision at the right time in terms of his future plan. My friend from the Kotak is sitting, he's an expert in this for the future plan for the entire country. I would like to divide financial literacy in two parts. Number one, just to spread awareness about the financial product and services available in our country. And number second, what are the risk factor involved in these financial services, because हम लोगों से जो एक अच्छे लोग हैं उनसे ज़्यादा समझदार और तेज़ आजकल के हैकर्स हैं. सो वी नीड टू टेक ऑल द प्रिकॉशंस फॉर द सेफ गार्ड ऑफ आवर मनी. सो इन द इंटायर माई लाइफ Because I have already told you, I am a telecom guy. In 2017, we took an initiative to respect financial literacy in across India. I was part of Vodafone. You can Google, there's a project, Jadu Ki Ginni. So we started that project and we arranged so many vehicles which are still going in fields, especially in villages, just to inform about the financial services and do's and don'ts. उसका हम लोग ने एक नाम दिया था गांव गांव मिली गली। तो गाड़ी जाती है हर गांव में, वहां के प्रधान से मुलाकात करती है और वहां पे एक लोगों के सेटअप गैदरिंग को एजुकेट करती है और क्रॉस क्वेश्चनिंग होती है। तो इस वोडाफोन यूजिंग एंड वी हैव आल्सो डेवलप्ड एन ऐप बाय द वोडाफोन फाउंडेशन संवाद करके। इन द संवाद ऐप पीपल कैन हैव एक्सेस टू द गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज एंड स्कीम्स as well as the financial literacy course also, and they will also certify it. So these are the some provisions done by the corporate, and many corporate will be doing this. Praveen ji has taken a such a wonderful initiative. When I was speaking with Praveen ji, he told me his entire life has gone in the financial banking sectors. I really appreciate it. You are taking it forward. So as you, I'm sitting on the question of Gaurav, in terms of cyber threats, what we can do. There are a number of hotlines and you can say emergency contact numbers from the police department also if somebody else. But still, we witness a number of elderly people and some business members, SMEs also, they are not aware. Yeah, even youth as well. But our Hindustan youth se bhara hua hai, humare, yeah, youth kafi samajhdar hai. इवन वी हैव सीन के अपनी फैमिली को यूथ ने भी बचाया। ऐसा कोई मैसेज आता है तो माता जो है अपने बच्चे से पूछती हैं, भाई देखो क्या है, वेदर वी शुड रिस्पॉन्ड और नॉट। तो यूथ इज ऑल्सो प्लेइंग इन द टॉपिक ऑफ दिस कन्वर्सेशन इज यूथ। यूथ इज प्लेइंग अ गुड रोल एंड वी नीड टू टेक इट फॉरवर्ड। अभी मीनाक्षी का एक बहुत अच्छा सुझाव है कि पैसे की कीमत बच्चों को जानना बहुत ज़रूरी है। अगर हम अपने बच्चों को 1,000 रुपये भी दे दें, उनसे कहें कि आप 1,000 रुपये कैसे यूटिलाइज करेंगे, दे विल बाय माइंड, दे विल गूगल कि व्हाट आर द रिसोर्सेज राइट नाउ। इन द सेम मैनर वी कैन आल्सो ऑर्गेनाइज कॉम्पिटिशंस एट अ रूरल लेवल। वुमेन कैन कम अप कि हाउ दे कैन, क्योंकि घर महिला ही चलाती, सो वुमेन कम अप विद इनिशिएटिव आइडियाज कि कैसे कर सकते हैं। एंड as the e-commerce chairman for Uttar Pradesh, I am willing and open if any of the NGO, any organization is started coming here and want to incorporate any sort of initiative with on the e-commerce platform. Because at a rural level, a smartphone and now e-commerce is also penetrating at a rural level. So it can be impactful just to safeguard these people, to give the प्रिकॉशनरी मेजर्स, डूज एंड डोंट्स टू वर बोले वाले लोग। तो आई थिंक आई एम ओपन, आई एम जस्ट स्पीकिंग ऑन फॉर एवरीबॉडी एंड इज ओपन फॉरम। आई एम ओपन इफ यू हैव एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ आइडिया इफ वी कैन इनकॉर्पोरेट फॉर द फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी, स्पेशली फॉर सेफ गार्डिंग अवर यूथ एंड एल्डरली पीपल अक्रॉस इंडिया। थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू हसन, यू गिव सम important some which we were not aware of, Jadu Ki Ginni, Gaon Gaon Gali, is an important aspect. And regarding this, you are saying that some do's and don'ts we can create for this financial theft. But still, I want you to know, is any, if someone used some online payment and he got trapped somewhere, so is there any timeline or such kind of a cyber crime is having some duration? Like we have in MSME, we have a forum where the this thing should resolve in 90 days or something. There's a duration. For cyber crimes, such kind of a deadline is there? Because I have seen so many people around us, they're trapped in this thing, but there is no duration or timeline, so there is no pressure they can create on this. So is there any...
I would like to emphasize and want to share my experience also. The promptness is necessarily required. If something has happened, आप उसको नहीं कर सकते, मान लिया आपके फादर से या मदर से कुछ OTP शेयर हो गया, शिलिंग हो गया, शेयर हो गया, बट इसके देयर आर चांसेस. लॉ इन्फोर्समेंट एजेंसीज हैज लॉन्च सो मेनी हॉटलाइन नंबर्स. इवन इन लखनऊ वी हैव अ इमरजेंसी नंबर लॉन्च बाय साइबर क्राइम. यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट हिम इमीडिएटली. व्हाट दे डू, दे जस्ट होल्ड द मनी इन द बैंक अकाउंट वेयर दैट कल्प्रिट या दैट हैकर हैज ट्रांसफर्ड. So this is a provision they have opted, I think, and people are getting fruitful and money is being returned also. And one thing I would like to highlight, it seems swiping is also a major problem. I'm a telecom guy and I have noticed N number of SIM swiping cases and they got the OTP and other relevant information which is also causing a transfer of money and by the fraudulent people. So we need, and DOT, I'm also representing Department of Telecommunication within the telecom industry. So DOT has already taken up few initiatives by sending precautionary message, do's and don'ts, and which people are getting irritated with this, but still there is a big scope of the awareness right now through e-commerce, telecom, smartphone, yeah, through any medium. Thank you.
So, Praveen ji, please.
So, I think what is very important हमारे युवा वर्ग के लिए, खासतौर से जैसे हमारे काफ़ी युवा वर्ग से आज FPOs भी पीछे बैठे हुए हैं, तो मैं थोड़ा सा इस बात को जरूर सभी अपने पैनलिस्ट से रिक्वेस्ट भी करता हूं कि हिंदी में वार्ता और संवाद जरूरी है. गांव-गांव गली-गली के साथ साथ हमारा हिंदी में संवाद जरूरी है. और अपने जो पैनलिस्ट मैडम बीना नायर जी और सर भी हैं, क्योंकि मैं ज़रूर चाहूँगा, क्योंकि क्या होता है हमारे 2018 से जब माननीय गवर्नर जी भी थे और उन्होंने तो फोर्स हिंदी में अपना भाषण दिया था, और मुझे लगता है कि सबसे पहले तो हमें सिंप्लीफाई करना है कैसे हम फाइनेंस को अपने पास लाएं. फाइनेंस से रोमांस तो होता नहीं है, फाइनेंस से हेट हो जाती है लोगों को. जैसे ही नाम लो फाइनेंस का तो यहाँ बात निकल जाते हैं साइड में, मतलब बच्चों से भी आप बात करोगे तो वो, हमारे कुछ बैंकर फ्रेंड भी हैं और कुछ लोग यहाँ पर फाइनेंस इंडस्ट्री से भी हैं, लेकिन ज़्यादातर तो बच्चे मुझसे इससे मतलब नहीं, मुझे पैसे दे दो. तो मेरा तो एक सबसे गुजारिश है, ये एक रिक्वेस्ट है, अनुरोध है कि हम लोग इसके बारे में बात जरूर करें फैमिली से, बच्चों में, बिकॉज फाइनेंशियल एम्पावरमेंट ऑफ यूथ कैन ओनली बिगिन विद द फैमिली फर्स्ट. तो पहले हम जो फैमिली को इससे कनेक्ट करें, एंड जैसा कि हमारे एस्टीम्ड स्पीकर्स ने बताया, ऑफकोर्स सुरेश जी पूरे ऑल इंडिया में हेड करते हैं, ही इनके पास पूरी नब्ज़ है कि कहाँ से पैसा आ रहा है डिमांड अकाउंट में. जैसे इन्होंने कहा कि मिलेनियल्स जो है पैसा लगा रहे हैं, जो 18 से 20 साल के बच्चे हैं, इनकी नई जॉब लगी है, और ये हम लोग देख रहे हैं. जो हम लोग भी जाते हैं, प्रोग्राम करते हैं, आजकल मैक्सिमम हमारे 60-70 प्रोग्राम जो वर्चुअली हो रहे हैं, कॉलेजेस में कई लोग अभी भी जुड़े हुए हैं, कॉलेजेस से यूथ जो जुड़े हुए हैं आज इस समय कार्यक्रम में, तो वो बहुत इसकी तरफ एक्साइटेड हो रहे हैं. और साथ में जो क्रिप्टो का एक समय बहुत बड़ा क्रेज़ है, which nobody can stop, which is going to come, no doubt. Abhi, despite RBI's all the, you know, caution against it, but still it is spreading very fast, because there is huge amount of advertisement, promotion, which is happening around this. But we have to be very careful about the risk part of such investments, which are not yet regulated. Jiska abhi koi regulator nahi hai, uske baare mein hume thoda sa saavdhani khud bhi rakhni hai aur bachcho ko bhi batani hai. बिकॉज एवरी वेर आई गेट दिस क्वेश्चन गेट्स आस्ट, एंड इवन इफ वॉट एवर आई से, मेरे सवाल मेरे जवाब का लोग इंतजार नहीं करते, उनको जो करना है वो करते हैं. तो हमें लगता है कि जो हमें फैमिली में यूथ को कनेक्ट करना है फाइनेंस से, वो वहाँ से शुरू होगा. जो एफर्ट्स हम लोग एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एज एन इन्वेस्टर एसोसिएशन इन UP, एंड एज एन NGO हम जो कर रहे हैं, वी विल सडनली टेक हेल्प ऑफ ऑल अवर पैनलिस्ट. सेवी से हमें रेगुलर सपोर्ट रहता है, और उसके माध्यम से भी बहुत से कार्यक्रम करते हैं. बीना मैडम हैं स्कूल्स के साथ में, हम लोग का इस साल का ये प्लान है कि स्कूल्स के साथ हम कुछ एसोसिएशन एक लॉन्ग टर्म पे करने जा रहे हैं. जैसे कॉलेज से हमने अभी MOU साइन किया. तो व्हाट वी वांट, हमारा थीम ही है कि बेसिक फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी हम अर्ली स्टार्ट करें. सो कैच देम यंग, जहाँ बोलते हैं ना, हर चीज़ में अगर हम जल्दी सिखाना शुरू करें बच्चे को. क्रिकेट IPL में आजकल लखनऊ की IPL टीम बन गई है, तो सारे बच्चे चालू हो गए, भाई IPL में जाना है तो बच्चे को शुरू से डाल दो क्रिकेट में, पैसे बनने लगेंगे. तो पैसे तो बनने लगेंगे, लेकिन वो पैसे क्या करेंगे बच्चा, ये पता नहीं है.
तो विनोद कामली बनेगा या फिर वो सनी तेंदुलकर बनेगा, उसका पैसा कौन मैनेज करेगा, ये भी हमको सिखाना है शुरू से. तो कैच देम यंग, गेट देम यू नो लर्न मनी स्किल्स अर्ली इन लाइफ. दैट इज माई मैसेज. बिकॉज ऑफ कोर्स नाउ आई वुड सडनली रिक्वेस्ट आवर जीपी गर्ल सर टू हैव हिज, यू नो व्हाट आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट आवर एस्टीम्ड पैनल इज दैट इफ दे कैन गिव अस वन और टू सच थॉट्स इन अ क्रिस्प मोड विच कैन एक्चुअली बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ नेक्स्ट वन ईयर. Every year we do this conclave in November and we evaluate ourselves that what have we done over a period of time. So वो मेरी request रहेगी कि youth के लिए हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं, अगर एक या दो sentence में हम लोग अगर ये बता सकें जो कि doable हो हमारे level पे, that is what I will request. So over to AGP Garg sir please.
DB कम करो. 18
voice.
24 करो तुम.
वो फोन लगा तक से लगी
है. मेरे फ्रेंड हैं जो कोटक सिक्योरिटी से, सुरेश जी ने बोला था कि व्हेन दे कैन इन्वेस्ट सीमलेसली म्यूचुअल फंड में या बाकी प्रोडक्ट्स के अंदर, क्यों ना फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी में भी होगा. दूसरा मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि अगर हम लोग कुछ ऐसा यूथ को ट्रेनिंग दें, जैसे हमारे नेशनल लेवल के इंस्टीट्यूट हैं, जैसे NISM है या बाकी और भी देख सकते हैं, जहां बच्चे फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट्स के बारे में सीखें, सर्टिफिकेशन लें और उसके बाद उनको जॉब भी मिले. इतनी कमी है उत्तर प्रदेश में, आप देखेंगे इतना कम पेनिट्रेशन हुआ है फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट्स का, कि अगर बच्चे हमारे इंस्टीट्यूट में सर्टिफिकेशन प्रोग्राम करें, उनके बारे में अच्छी जानकारी लें. लेकिन पीएफपी म्यूचुअल फंड सेलर्स और एनपीएस और इंश्योरेंस में बहुत स्कोप है बच्चों के लिए, और उससे दोनों फायदा होगा. उनको एक उनका खुद का फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी भी बढ़ेगा और उनको एक तरह से जॉब भी मिलेगा. तो ये मेरे दो मेन सुझाव हैं. बाकी मैं मैडम यहाँ पर हैं बीना जी, उनसे ये भी जानना चाहूंगा अगर वो बता सके विच इज द बेस्ट पेडागोजी फॉर यू नो यूथ. हम लोग हमेशा ये सोचते हैं कि शायद उनको किताब लेके पढ़ाया जाए, जबकि वो बड़ा मुश्किल है. हम ये दो पाँच मिनट से ज्यादा नहीं पढ़ सकते. आजकल हमारा जो कंसेंट्रेशन लेवल बहुत लो हो गया है. तो अगर हमको फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी आगे देनी है, जैसे मैंने बताया कि एप्स वगैरह और कुछ वो अगर सुझाव दे तो हम कोशिश करेंगे उसको इम्प्लीमेंट करें. ओवर टू यू.
So much, sir. I would say that experiential learning. हर स्कूल में बच्चों को बैंक में विजिट कराएं और उनको बताएं कि कैसे इसको. हम लोग जब स्कूल में थे, एक स्कीम होता था संजय का एक स्कीम होता था. ऐसे कुछ स्कीम स्टार्ट करें और कंपलसरी करें बच्चों में सेविंग्स का जो है वो शुरू से बच्चों में एक वो आना चाहिए. हाउ टू सेव मनी, वाई टू सेव मनी एंड वेयर टू सेव मनी, है ना. ये सारे बच्चों को आना चाहिए राइट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग एंड देन इट बिकम्स अ हैबिट. जैसे नॉलेज हो गया, स्किल हो गया, एटीट्यूड हो गया एंड देन दैट शुड बिकम अ हैबिट. काश देन ओनली द काश विल कंप्लीट. सो आई थिंक वी शुड ऑल एम टू कंप्लीट द काश इन द स्टूडेंट्स राइट फ्रॉम द स्कूल लेवल एंड मूव इट टू द कॉलेज and then help them you know get experience of it. I think only then we will be able to you know improve the financial literacy of our country in totality. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. I would request now Suresh.
So I think बहुत सारी चीजें कर सकते हैं, but most important thing जो गर्ग साहब ने बोला, मैडम ने बोला, I think we should catch them young. मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग और सारा फोकस जो वहाँ पर होना चाहिए, जो रूट कॉज ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्कूल कॉलेजेस, दैट इज़ द प्लेस जहाँ पर लर्निंग एबिलिटी काफ़ी हाई होती है. इफ़ आई मैं किसी को 40 साल में सिखाऊँ या किसी को मैं 10 साल में सिखाऊँ, बड़ा फर्क होता है उसमें. सो आई थिंक दैट इज़ वेयर वी शुड फोकस. एंड आई थिंक सारे स्टेक होल्डर्स को इसमें कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करना पड़ेगा. जैसे टॉकिंग अबाउट आर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, we are utilizing our CSR fund in a program called Kona Kona Shiksha in collaboration with NISM. I'm sure that sir ko pata hoga. So exactly yahi karne ki koshish hum kar rahe hain ki Kona Kona Shiksha mein we can reach to tier 2 tier 3 cities ke schools and colleges. Humne NISM ke help se curriculum banaya hai. We are trying to teach them basics. So I think the most important thing is root cause pe attack karna chahiye. That is what is my view is.
Hasan ji is from the e-commerce which all of us are using every day. तो e-commerce के माध्यम से हम लोग कैसे वित्तीय शिक्षा को, अब मैं किसी को वित्तीय बोलता हूँ तो वो पूरा थोड़ा सा चौंक जाता है, वित्तीय क्या होता है. तो मैंने किसी को वित्तीय जागरूकता बोला तो लोग बोलते हैं ये कुछ नया बोल दिया आपने. तो हिंदी में थोड़ा मुश्किल है, फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी, फाइनेंस लोग आते हैं. तो हाउ ऑन थ्रू ई कॉमर्स वी कैन गेट फाइनेंशियल एम्पावरमेंट ऑन फाइनेंशियल एजुकेशन तो आपसे.
सो ई कॉमर्स आई थिंक प्लेइंग अ सिग्निफिकेंट रोल इन द अपडेवलपमेंट एज अ रूरल एरिया प्लस एमएसएमई सेलर्स. So, other than the student wonderful initiatives suggested by our panelists, for the SMEs basically, we are very well connected with the SMEs because we are having a seller support system. हजारों लड़के हमारे इस MSMEs को support करने के लिए online हैं. तो we can organize some sort of program कि हमारे portal पे आते हैं, बेचने के लिए आते हैं. उसी के साथ we can add on some sort of financial literacy program and many organizations which are e-commerce are working for the upliftment of MSME, artisans, women entrepreneur, startups. So we can also engage them and switch some add-on literature to function this year. This is my humble suggestion.
So Flipkart is everybody is using now. You know Flipkart ko koi aisa naam hi nahi jaanta jaise WhatsApp ho gaya, Flipkart ho gaya. To mujhe lagta hai ki uske प्लेटफॉर्म पे जाकर के अगर हमें कुछ खरीदना है, बेचना है और साथ में हम उसके साथ साथ कुछ सीख पाएँ फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी के बारे में भी, स्पेशली जैसे जो छोटे माइक्रो इंटरप्राइज जो अभी बात हो रही थी एमएसएमई में, उनके लिए बहुत मुश्किल होता है कि वो कैसे अपना बजट बनाएं, कैसे अपनी सेविंग और स्पेंडिंग बनकर को मैनेज करें, कितना प्रॉफिट हो रहा है, उसको कितना पोर्शन निकाल के इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं. ये बहुत छोटी सी चीज़ होती है लेकिन हम लोग तो देखते हैं कि माइक्रो इंटरप्राइजेस ये नहीं कर पाते हैं. तो उनके पास तो इतना गले में कैश आ गया सोचते हैं मेरा इनकम हो गया हो, उनको पता ही नहीं कि मुझे ये दुकान का भाड़ा भी देना है, मुझे ये मेरा ये नौकर भी है जो दुकान में काम कर रहा है उसका भी सेट. तो वो जोड़ मेरा बेसिक जो फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी का मतलब ये है कि सब कुछ. और कई बार वो जो आदमी फंक्शनल लिटरेसी नहीं होती है, जिसको शायद वो बी ए एम ए और एम एस सी और एम बी ए नहीं होता है, उसकी फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी ज़्यादा होती है. कई बार ऐसे लोग भी हैं मुंबई में आई टेल यू पान वाला जो आर मल्टी मिलियनियर्स, वो फाइनेंशियली लिटरेट है, हो सकता है उनका फॉर्मल एजुकेशन नहीं होगा. सो दैट इज वेयर आई थिंक वी हैव टू हिट एंड इंटरवीन दैट हाउ वी ब्रिंग दिस बैलेंस. एंड जैसा कि मैडम ने कहा एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग, एंड सर ने बोला कि हाउ वी कैन एक्चुअली यू नो गो अक्रॉस टू द कॉलेजेस थ्रू NISM कोर्सेज एंड सर्टिफिकेशंस, बिकॉज फाइनेंशियल एजुकेशन कैन ओनली इम्पावर यू नो, बट फाइनेंशियल इम्पावरमेंट यू नो मेक्स यू रियली स्ट्रॉन्ग. तो मुझे लगता है फाइनेंशियल इम्पावरमेंट के लिए जरूरी है कि हम उसको अर्ली स्टेज पे इंट्रोड्यूस करें, एंड दैट इज वेयर दिस पैनल वाज एक्चुअली फोकसिंग. सो ओवर टू गौरव एंड ऑफ कोर्स हिज पार्टिंग व्यूज ऑन बिकॉज ही इज फ्रॉम इज वर्किंग ही इज फ्रॉम ईएमआई वर्किंग विद द गवर्नमेंट, सो ही इज लुकिंग आफ्टर द एंटायर थिंग. तो मुझे लगता है कि अपने इंडिविजुअल सेल्फ से लेकर के हम सब लोग चारों लोग बैठे हैं अलग अलग लेवल के फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी में हैं, तो वो अपना एक्सपीरियंस गौरव बताएंगे.
सो बचपन से जैसे आदत डालने की बात बिना मैम ने कही है, तो पहले एक कॉन्सेप्ट हुआ करता था पॉकेट मनी का. हमारे बचपन में तो पॉकेट मनी हुआ करता था, अभी तो पॉकेट मनी अभी नाम नहीं लूँगा किसी सेलिब्रिटी किड को बहुत ज़्यादा मिलता था. तो जब पॉकेट मनी लिमिटेड हुआ करता था तो हमें शायद थोड़ी समझ होती थी पैसे कितने खर्चे करने, कैसे खर्चे करने हैं. तो जैसा हसन ने कहा कि हम लोग अभी जो भी स्टेक होल्डर हैं हसन के MSME से रिलेटेड हैं, बिल्कुल, बल्कि सुरेश सर ने कहा कि सारे स्टेक होल्डर को एक साथ आना पड़ेगा. जैसे अवोक इंडिया है, अवोक इंडिया जो भी ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम्स करता है, फ्लिपकार्ट जो भी ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम्स करता है, क्या उनके साथ हमें छोटा सा एक फाइनल लिटरेसी का उसमें ऐड किया जा सकता है. चाहे वो अवोक इंडिया काफ़ी इसमें एजुकेशन सेक्टर में भी काम कर रहा है, तो जहाँ जहाँ पर इस तरह के कोई भी ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम हो रहे हैं उनमें छोटा सा पार्ट फाइनल लिटरेसी का भी डाला जा सकता है. गवर्नमेंट से रिलेटेड भी जितने SHGs हैं और FPOs हैं उनके भी बहुत सी चीज़ें प्रॉब्लम होती हैं. मैंने पहले ही कहा था एक्सेस टू फाइनेंस बहुत मैटर करता है. जितने भी छोटे माइक्रो सेक्टर हैं उनकी सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम ये है कि उनको बैंक के पास रीच नहीं हो पाती है, क्योंकि उनके पास जो एक पेज का कॉन्सेप्ट नोट है, दो पेज का कॉन्सेप्ट नोट होता है, उनका प्रोजेक्ट वाइबल होगा कि नहीं होगा वो पता नहीं होता है. अगर उनको बेसिक नॉलेज भी रहे तो कम से कम उस पर थोड़ा वो काम कर सकते हैं. तो इसको कह के मैं अपनी बात को खत्म करना चाहूँगा और प्रवीण जी
थैंक यू वेरी मच आई थिंक इट्स आई होप इफ देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द ऑडियंस वी वुड लव टू हैव अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम anyone who wants to ask Mr. Shri Hantesh Kumar he wants to ask a question please there is a mic there also
hello good afternoon ladies and gentlemen first of all thank you so much it was a very enlightening topic main thoda sa aapko apna batata hu मैंने इंजीनियरिंग करी है आईआईटी से कंप्लीट की थी आई डी से फिर मैं लास्ट 25 साल बुलाया से दस मिनट का तो मेरा एक्सेस इंफॉर्मेशन नॉलेज के लिए काफ़ी अच्छा था मैं जैसे लास्ट रिलायंस में था तो भी रिलायंस में आर्ट यूनिवर्सिटी है तो हम लोग काफ़ी प्राइड करते हैं शायद इंडिया में वहाँ सबसे ज़्यादा इंफॉर्मेशन ग्लोबल स्कूल्स का एक्सेस है सब कुछ बट हम लोग की जो फाइनेंशियल एजुकेशन है मैं अपने ही बोलता हूँ बहुत बुरा मैं क्योंकि पिछले 2 साल पहले मेरे को रियलाइज हुआ कि अगर मेरे को 2 साल से रियलाइज हो रहा है कि अगर मेरे को थोड़ी समझ ज़्यादा होती तो मैं अकाउंट ए से अकाउंट बी में अगर अपने पैसे डाले होते तो आज जितने मेरे पास पैसे उसके कम से कम डबल ट्रिपल तो होते
फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी जो हम लोग सर्वे करते हैं उस सर्वे में आई थिंक मोस्टली हम लोग कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट की बात करते हैं इन्फ्लेशन के बारे में पता है कि नहीं पता है कुछ सर्वे के पॉइंट्स होते हैं उसके बेसिस पे डिसाइड होता है बट यू आर राइट आई थिंक एट एवरी लेवल दैट शुड बी रिड्यूस्ड सो मे आई रिक्वेस्ट द एंकर टू प्लीज गेट द मोमेंटोज वी वुड बी रैपिंग अप दिस सेशन इन केस एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चन सो थैंक यू वेरी मच ऑल द पैनलिस्ट एंड ऑफ कोर्स गौरव मॉडरेटर फॉर द सेशन And of course, our ED sir, GP Garg, we cannot of course reach out to you and Madam Bina Naharji for expressing our thanks for us. We will certainly meet up sometime soon and look forward to taking your guidance further. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you very much. We wish you all your growing plant of wealth and wisdom both, which is what a money plant signifies. So thank you very much. We formally close this panel for youth, hoping that youth gets financially empowered with our initiatives in this coming year. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Garg, and thank you, Madam. Namaskar.